Polar species have quickly become the face of climate change because of stories like this. Loss of Antarctic sea ice caused a catastrophic breeding failure for emperor penguins. We're going to be talking about why this happened, what it means, and because I'm an optimist, we're also going to be spending some time talking about the good news and what we can do to help this incredible species. I'm KP, and I've worked with several penguins throughout my career as a marine biologist. Emperor penguins are the iconic symbol of Antarctica. Their incredible and unique survival in such a harsh environment has been portrayed countless times in film and media, most famously in the 2005 documentary March of the Penguins. I would also argue that Happy Feet was a really important piece as well. Every year at the end of the Antarctic summer, emperor penguins leave the ocean and march inland to their breeding grounds where they practice seasonal monogamy. We do say seasonal monogamy because it is unfortunately a bit of a myth that penguins mate for life. If the breeding pair is successful, then they might absolutely seek out each other for the following year. But if they didn't successfully raise a chick, or if last year's partner is a no-show, or if some better-looking penguin becomes available, then they will move on and find a different mate. I think the average is that around 15% of breeding pairs mate again the following year. Every year brings new penguins that have just grown up and are now looking for a mate, and there is a courtship that happens. Penguins, like a lot of birds, are flirtatious. One of the ways that penguins can flirt is by preening each other, like these two Magellanic penguins. They'll also perform for potential partners with bowing and wing flapping. But once they decide on a mate and the courtship is successful, the female will lay a single egg in the species. Not all of these eggs hatch. I don't know the numbers for emperor penguins, but in the species I've worked with, like the Magellanic penguins, only about one out of every three chicks successfully hatch and fledge. So the odds are already stacked against them. For emperor penguins, in order for their chicks to survive, both parents need to make several perilous treks across the ice and into the ocean in order to feed them. Then they need to march back to their breeding grounds in order to feed the chick. This journey seems like a ridiculous amount of work, but the reason for it is pretty simple. Just like all birds, penguin chicks are vulnerable. Baby robins can't fly when they're born, and baby penguins can't swim. If they fall into the water, they will drown. Penguins are uniquely adapted to life in the ocean. Their feathers are waterproof, but that's not the case for the newborn chicks. They're born with a different kind of feather called a down feather. This down feather keeps them warm and protects them from the harsh Antarctic climate, but it cannot protect them from water. You probably know where this is going, and if it's not for you, then I totally understand. Just click on this link up here. It'll take you to a video that I promise will brighten your day. But if you do have the stomach for it, I think that it is important that we talk about this situation that happened, because it is going to continue to happen unless we do something about it. As I was saying, the ice on which penguins breed needs to remain stable long enough for the chicks to develop those waterproof feathers. But thanks to climate change, that is not what happened. The event occurred in late 2022 on the western coast of Antarctica, and it was recorded by satellites. The ice underneath the penguin chicks melted and broke apart before they could develop those waterproof feathers that we talked about that they need to survive in the ocean. The birds most likely drowned or even froze to death. This is like the saddest thing I have ever heard. Of the five breeding sites in the region, all but one experienced a total breeding failure before the start of the fledging period. This is the first recorded incident of a widespread breeding failure of emperor penguins that's clearly linked to a loss of sea ice. We're talking about tens of thousands of baby penguins gone. And it gets worse. Because of this event, scientists are predicting that more than 90% of emperor penguin colonies are going to be all but extinct by the end of the century, as the continent's seasonal sea ice withers in an ever-warming world. So, but in the beginning of the video, I did promise I would talk about some good news, and there is some. It's something called the Species Survival Plan, or SSP. SSPs are programs designed to ensure the survival of selected species that are threatened or endangered in the wild. Some famous examples are the California condor, the American red wolf, and the black-footed ferret. There are also species survival plans for penguins. The facility I currently work at is part of an SSP for Magellanic penguins. This is Regina. She was born this year. Regina is fully fledged, has her waterproof feathers, and will hopefully have chicks of her own in the near future. The widespread success of SSPs also includes species reintroduction programs. Another good thing is emperor penguins are known to adapt to breeding failures caused by the collapse of the sea ice. They have been documented moving to more stable sites in the past. And while I hope the same thing happens for the colonies impacted by this current event, we can't rely on this possibility if breeding habitats continue to be unstable thanks to global warming. That's why we need to make global climate change a global responsibility. Elect leaders who, at the very least, acknowledge that it's happening. Get out there and vote for a responsible future. Because the truth is, these vulnerable species, penguins, polar bears, snow crab? It's not gonna stop at them. We're next. We're seeing it every day with wildfires in Hawaii, hurricanes in California, and the collapse of an entire species. But if you do come across a good news marine bio story, please drop it in the comments down below. I wanna hear about some of the good things that are going on in the ocean. As always, like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. And I'll catch you next time.